In this last part of the series, I'm going to show you a method I frequently use to make my interview cuts feel as smooth as possible. First of all, I'd like to thank Luciana Pandolfelli for introducing me to this method. She's a very talented and accomplished film editor in Italy, and I was fortunate to work with her a little over 10 years ago. Let's look at this sentence from a documentary I'm developing called The Missing Head, which I'm also directing.
We've got mathematical models of our proteome, of our genome, of our connectome, all the connections and informational, bioinformatic connections in the brain.
If we had to cut part of this sentence on paper, the logical place to cut would be between words, as in text, each word is separated from the other. But let's listen to the same sentence and pay close attention. You'll notice there aren't any real pauses between words. They blend together in kind of a rhythm.
Our genome, of our connectome, all the connections and informational, bioinformatic connections in the brain.
When we examine the audio waveform, this becomes even more apparent.
Our genome, of our connectome, all the connections and informational, bioinformatic connections in the brain.
Most of the visible pauses don't align exactly with the end of any word. They seem almost random. So let's try to make the cut. Here the concept is repeated multiple times and is sometimes misspelled. We need to state it just once in a clear and effective way. In writing, this would be straightforward. We'd keep the parts we like by cutting at the end of each word.
We've got mathematical models of our proteome, of our genome, of our connectome, all the bioinformatic connections in the brain.
The cuts sound quite jumpy and the pitch is all over the place. Let's listen to another example.
Otherwise, the works that we do, works like the Philip K. Dick Android, are curiosities.
In this clip, the subject repeats part of the answer twice.
The works that we do, works like the Philip K. Dick Android.
Even though he says works twice, the letters sound different because they have a different pitch.
Works, works.
They are not exactly the same word. So if on paper we would write the works like the Philip Dick Android, the cut doesn't quite sound natural.
Otherwise, the works like the Philip K. Dick Android?
We'll have to adjust the cut until we find a convincing place. So is there a way to create a smooth sounding cut that isn't affected by pitch and constantly sounds natural? The solution is looking for voiceless letters. Voiceless letters are letters that don't require the larynx to vibrate. Without vibration, there is no pitch in their sound, so they're always pronounced the same way. For example, the sound of P, which is P, T is T, and K is K. These letters are often preceded by a small pause.
Of our connectome.
S and F, on the other hand, have longer, unpitched sound. S and if you look at the audio waveform again, we see these letters lining with the pauses we found. These letters provide an opportunity to cut mid-word, either just before or during one of these sounds. Since people often repeat themselves when speaking, you can look for any of these letters and make your cut right there.
We need AIs that are meditation assistants, that are teachers, that are elder care workers, that are therapists, that are scientists. We need AIs doing loving, positive, compassionate things.
For example, in the first sentence, we'll cut mid-word in the word teachers.
We need AIs that are meditation assistants, that are teachers.
Keeping teacher from the first part.
Therapists, that are scientists.
And from scientists from the second part.
We need AIs that are meditation assistants, that are teachers. We need AIs doing loving, positive, compassionate things.
In the second sentence, we'll keep work from the first and x from the second, taking advantage of the pause generated by the sounds k and s.
Works. Otherwise, the works like the Philip K. Dick Android.
You can also use this method to cut between different parts of the interview by finding a similar pattern and cutting on the voiceless letters.
We've got mathematical models of our proteome, of our genome, of our connectome, all the connections and informational, bioinformatic connections in the brain.
For example, you can cut mid-word in connections, which is repeated twice, using the second K in connections as the cutting point.
All the connections, informational, bioinformatic connections. We've got mathematical models of our genome, of our connectome, all the connections in the brain.
The result will sound natural. There is one exception to this method. If the cut is right after a strong vowel, such as a loud E, and there's a lot of reverb in the room, you might perceive the E with a different pitch in the background of the voiceless letter. In this case, cut before the strong vowel. Finally, hide the cut by offsetting the video and audio cuts.
It works like the Philip K. Dick Android.
Place the mouse between the two clips and move the video cut a few frames before or after the audio cut. If you're cutting mid-word in a repeated phrase, you can try using the full word in the video from one of the two versions.
It works like the Philip K. Dick Android.
No one will notice the slight audio sync discrepancy.
Otherwise, it works like the Philip K. Dick Android are curiosities.
In the previous videos, I discussed how to organize and create multicam clips and share my thought process from start to finish when editing an interview-based video. Check out the other videos on my channel.